In this video, I'm going to demonstrate Python's dictionary data structure by creating a program that computes the mode for a list of values entered by the user. The mode of a list is the value that occurs with greatest frequency. If a list has two or more values that occur with greatest frequency, then it has multiple modes. An empty list does not have a mode. Let's begin by writing some comments that describe the steps we're going to take to solve this problem. We'll begin by reading all of the values from the user and storing them in a list. The user will enter a blank line to indicate that all the values have been entered. Then we'll compute the mode for the list. To do so, we'll use a dictionary where the keys are elements from the list. Each value in the dictionary will be the number of times that the element occurs in the list. We'll start with an empty dictionary, and then we'll process each item from the list. If the element is already in the dictionary, then we'll increase its value by 1. Otherwise, we'll add a new key to the dictionary with a value of 1. Once the dictionary has been populated, we can use it to compute the mode. We'll use an if statement to determine whether or not any values were actually entered by the user. When values were entered, we need to find the maximum value in the dictionary and then report all of the keys that have that maximum value. If the user didn't enter any values, then we'll display an appropriate message. Now it's time to write the Python code that implements the steps in our algorithm. We'll begin by creating a new empty list to hold all of the values entered by the user. Then we'll read the first value. We'll use a while loop so that our program continues to read values until a blank line is entered. The body of the while loop will append the previous value to the end of the list and then read the next value from the user. The append is performed before the input in the body of the loop because the first value was read outside of the loop. The next step is to create a new empty dictionary. An empty dictionary is denoted by an open brace followed by a close brace. Then we'll use a for loop to process each item in the list. We can determine whether or not an item is already in the dictionary by using an if statement. The condition on the if statement will use Python's in operator to determine if the current item is already in the dictionary's keys. If it is, we'll retrieve the previous value from the dictionary, add 1 to it, and then overwrite the old value in the dictionary using an assignment statement. Otherwise, we'll add a new key to the dictionary. We'll use another if statement to determine whether or not the user entered any values. Finding the maximum value could be accomplished using a for loop, but it's easier to use Python's built-in max function. The values from the dictionary are passed to max as its only parameter, and max returns the largest value in that collection. We'll display a message describing our program's output with a print statement, and then we'll use a for loop to find all of the keys in the dictionary that have maximum value. The for loop will iterate over each key in the dictionary, and its body will compare the value in the dictionary to the maximum value. If the values match, then the key is displayed because it's one of the modes for the list. Note that we don't have any control over the order in which the keys are processed, but we are guaranteed that they will all be processed. Finally, we'll display an appropriate message if the user didn't enter any values. Let's see what happens when we run the program. We'll begin by entering several values, some of which are repeated. Each value is added to the end of the list after it's entered. Then the user enters a blank line, which causes the while loop to terminate. The next line of code creates the counts dictionary. The dictionary is initially empty, with no keys and no values. The for loop will run once for each value in data. The first value is A, so Python sets item equal to A and runs the body of the loop. A is not a key in the counts dictionary, so the condition on the if statement evaluates to false, which causes Python to skip the body of the if statement and run the body of the else statement. The body of the else statement adds A to the dictionary as a new key with the value 1. Then Python returns to the top of the loop, assigns B to item, and runs the loop body again. The condition on the if statement evaluates to false because B is not a key in counts, so Python skips the body of the if statement and runs the body of the else statement. The body of the else statement adds B to the dictionary with a value of 1. Python returns to the top of the loop and runs it again for the next item, which is also B. B is a key in the dictionary, which means that the condition on the if statement is true, so Python runs the body of the if statement. The value currently stored in the dictionary for B, which is 1, is retrieved. One is added to it, and the new total is stored back into the dictionary, replacing the previous value. The body of the else statement is skipped, and Python returns to the top of the for loop. The next item is A. A is already a key in the dictionary, so the condition on the if statement is true. When its body runs, the current value for A is retrieved, 1 is added to it, and the new total is stored back into the dictionary, replacing the previous value. Control returns to the top of the loop, and C is stored into item. The condition on the if statement is false, so the body of the else statement runs, which adds C to the dictionary with the value 1. Then Python returns to the top of the loop and stores A into item. This time the condition on the if statement is true, so Python runs its body. Python retrieves the previous value, which is 2, adds 1 to it, and stores 3 into the dictionary. When Python returns to the top of the loop, there are no remaining values to process, so it goes on and runs the rest of the program. The condition on this if statement is true, so Python runs its body. The max function finds the largest value in the dictionary, which is 3, and stores it into the largest value variable. Then the output message is displayed, and the for loop is executed. I'll assume that the values are processed in alphabetical order, however, the actual order that Python uses could be different. A is stored into item and the body of the loop runs. The value in the dictionary for key A is equal to the largest value, so the condition on the if statement is true, which causes Python to display an A. Control returns to the top of the loop and B is stored into item. The condition on the if statement evaluates to false, the body of the if statement is skipped, control returns to the top of the loop and C is stored into item. Once again, the condition on the if statement is false, so the body of the if statement is skipped, and control returns to the top of the loop. Then our program terminates because there are no further statements to execute. This program has demonstrated Python's dictionary data structure by computing the mode of a list of values entered by the user. I hope that watching this video has increased your understanding of this topic.